Look, SIPTU's position on privatisation has been constant. It's a bad deal for the taxpayer, the worker and the travelling public. We have seen countless examples of the chaos in London with the privatisation where taxpayers are paying more and more. For the last 2.5 years since this plan was announced, we have campaigned, lobbied, advocated and given our alternative analysis that it shouldn't proceed. That being said, the government are very clear that they intend to proceed on this. We've been accused of having a political strike when we had a 48-hour stoppage 2 weeks ago. It's a trade dispute. You can't have a political strike. So we are against the privatisation agenda, but we cannot stop the government from proceeding. But what we've always wanted to do was to protect our members today and protect the future of public transport tomorrow by addressing the consequences of privatisation. And with our SIPTU 6-point agenda, we have done that, whereby the agreement last night has effectively vindicated 5.5 of those points. So I'd be optimistic and confident that if everybody honours the commitments they've signed up to last night and the words match the deeds of the employer, the Department of Transport and the National Transport Authority, we will have industrial peace. And our members who work in Dublin Bus and Bus Éireann can go forward with confidence, with the security of their employment, and we can also try and create a sector employment order for the publicly funded bus market of which the privates operate in, to try and lift the floor and get a proper living and social wage for bus workers out there in the economy.